300,000 years ago, a new cold period started in the middle of the Solian Ice Age, and the ice sheet advanced again extensively. Soon, the Homo heidelbergensis, who lived mostly in France, Spain, and Italy, in Western Europe, evolved into the early Neanderthals. They preferred the warmer wooded areas over the colder mammoth steppe. Unlike their ancestors, the Neanderthals were adapted for cold climates. They had a more robust build, specialized body fat storage, proportionally shorter limbs to conserve heat, an enlarged nose to warm the air, and were a bit smaller. Adults reached only 147 to 177 centimeters, 4.8 to 5.8 feet in height. They had brown eyes and brown hair, and some even had red hair. They had dark skin color, though the lack of sunlight led to the proliferation of lighter skin. Although they were able to speak at a higher level than other primates, they were incapable of producing a large range of speech sounds, as they lacked the capacity for articulate speech. Neanderthals had a low population and lived in sparsely distributed groups of 10 to 30 individuals. There were also intergroup conflicts, as there was regular communication between communities within a region, but not as often beyond. They were cave dwellers, preferring caves whose entrance faced south towards the sun. They moved between caves seasonally, and they returned to the same locations generation after generation. Open-air settlements were also used, but more as slaughtering and butchering grounds. They could make fire, and they built hearths to keep warm, defend themselves from animals, and also to cook food by roasting meat, legumes, and acorns. To stay warm while sleeping, they made many evenly spaced hearths inside caves, lined up against the rock wall so that each person could sleep on either side of each fire. The smoke flowed upwards to the ceiling and then outside the cave. Neanderthals used the prepared core technique for greater control over the size and shape of the scrapers, knives, or projectile levelwa points. They made wooden spears that had been debarked, and the ends had been sharpened using cutting and scraping. Some were also hafted with stone spear tips. They were either thrown or used as handheld thrusting spears. In coastal sites in Italy and Greece, they crafted scrapers from smooth clam shells used for hide working. They commonly made hides from treated animal skins. Like their ancestors, they made engravings on flint cortexes, on slabs, and on pebbles. They used ochre, but also collected a variety of unusual objects without any real functional purpose, mainly quartz crystals, but also sericite, iron pyrite, calcite, and galena. They fed mainly on red deers and reindeers, the most abundant game. They were ambush hunters, getting close to and attacking their target in a short burst of speed, thrusting in a spear at close quarters. They slaughtered whole herds of animals in large hunts, including Irish elk, ibex, wild horse, steppe wisent, aurochs, woolly rhinoceros, wild boar, and also giants, 4 meters 13 feet, straight-tusked elephants, and woolly mammoths. While steppe-dwelling communities subsisted almost entirely on meat from large game, those living in forests also consumed smaller animals like rabbits and ground-dwelling birds and foraged many edible plants and mushrooms. Waterside communities were also gathering aquatic resources. On the Iberian, Italian, and Peloponnesian peninsulas, Neanderthals exploited marine resources like shellfish, crabs, fish, seals, and even dolphins. They still competed with large predators like wolves, cave bears, cave lions, leopards, and cave hyenas. To defend a kill against them, they engaged in a group display of yelling, arm waving, or stone throwing, or abandoned the kill. Life was tough. Infant mortality was very high, almost half in northern Eurasia. Furthermore, around 15% were injured before reaching adulthood. Almost all suffered and healed a major trauma in their life, with almost half being severely injured. Like their ancestors, they were caring for the most vulnerable within the community, and individuals with highly debilitating injuries were nursed for several years. Still, about 80% died before the age of 40. 100,000 years later, during a warmer period, Neanderthals produced tar through the dry distillation of birch bark and used it as a backing on small stone tools. 20,000 years later, During the last cold period of the Solian Ice Age, the glaciation reached its maximum extent. Britain was covered in ice sheets and became uninhabited. 4,000 years later, in a large chamber deep inside the Brunichel Cave in France, Neanderthals made two rings, several meters wide, from broken stalagmite pieces. 6,000 years later, fur clothing became widely used by hominins. Neanderthals, especially those in colder climates, crafted simple clothes similar to blankets and ponchos using hide scrapers. Also, at Poggetti Vecchi in Italy, they used fire to process boxwood branches to make digging sticks for digging up foods out of the ground. Not long after, Neanderthals spread west to the Apodema Cave in southern Greece. Within 20,000 years, Carian Cave in southern Anatolia was also inhabited. After the Sali Ice Age ended, Neanderthals' numbers increased dramatically in Western, Central, Eastern, and Mediterranean Europe. Within 10,000 years, they reached the Tabun Cave and Nesher Ramla in Levant, making contact with Homo sapiens and even starting interbreeding with them. Meanwhile, the Neanderthals spread up to the Denisova Cave. Within 13,000 years, they managed to cross the sea and reach the Crete Island. The ice sheet extended again during the Weichselian Ice Age. After around 1,000 years, in areas of Europe and the Middle East, Neanderthals started to bury their dead in simple, shallow graves and pits. Goods, like flint tools, were also left in the grave. 10,000 years later, during the first cold period of the last ice age, they suffered a major population decline. During the warmer period that followed, Neanderthals returned to Britain, but their total population remained low. 9,000 years later, bone has been used for making tools by virtually all hunter-gatherer societies. At Abri-Peroni, animal rib lessors were rubbed against hide to make it more supple or waterproof. Humans, with superior technology, expanded north to Eastern Europe, replacing the Neanderthals who could not compete due to their small population size, interbreeding, and assimilation with modern humans. After around 3,000 years, humans replaced the Neanderthals in Central Asia. Some 3,500 years later, Homo sapiens arrived at Kent's Cavern in England. Within 1500 years, the last surviving archaic humans in Iberia were replaced by Homo sapiens. All Neanderthals are now extinct. Thank you for traveling back in time with us on this historical journey. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Leave a comment and select all notifications for more videos like this one. Until next time, keep exploring the past to understand the present and even foresee the future.